Hey there, it's so this is our new show. It's new because we didn't do it yet, but it is Jim and Tay. What you say?
You changed it.
I changed it. Or Jim and Tay have their say.
We're what trying to think? Come up with a name. Let us know in the comments below if you have any ideas.
Please, we need a name for the show. It's always a struggle.
We're too in it.
We're too close to it.
Yeah. Well, you know, we were talking a little bit earlier, right before now. Kind of made me think about something that I was already thinking of. And something that I've seen, you know, being an actor, being an artist, sometimes you have lulls with summer or whatever.
A lot.
Holidays. People just are not really working because the business is shut down and people are off and they're on their vacation. But I'm curious, like when you were starting off your career, what sort of things did you do during those lulls?
Good question. Yeah, an actor's life is mostly lull. It's lull, long periods of lull interrupted by intense bits of activity.
It's a lullaby.
It's a lullaby. In my case, I just continue to create stuff and get these things out. Now, what happens is when you're first starting out, it's like the business that you want to get in, the industry, the game, whatever you want to call it, is like this train that's going down the road. And you see it in the distance. He's like, what is that? That looks amazing. It's at night and it's all lit up and it's letting out a mournful whistle. And then you get closer to it and closer. You go, I just want to get close to that train, find out what it is. I've heard it's great. Then you see it whizzing by and you're like, oh my God, how do I get on that train? Right?
Yeah.
And you notice, well, it does stop here and there, but mostly it's going. So how do I get on that train? So just to carry this metaphor, I don't even know exactly how apt it's going to be after a certain point, but I mean, there are places where the train stops and it's like, okay, everybody on. And you're like, wow, hey, I'm on the train. This is great. There are other times where you're like, I'm going to get on that train. So, it's definitely about persistence. Also, the train is, these days, the train is changing shape, or it doesn't stay on the rails anymore. It goes off that way. Like, whoa, I didn't even know a train could go that way. I guess the thing to realize is that all plays, all screenplays, all movie projects, anything are not naturally occurring events, you know, beyond dispute or discussion. They are not forces of nature. They are the result of individual creation.
Right.
So any of the rules that apply to getting to know somebody or meeting an individual that may someday put you to work, that applies. And also, like, hey, I'm an individual, you know, I can do my own thing. Now, I got busy, very busy. As I was starting my acting career, I was also starting working with a theater, with the Improv Theater, the National Improv Theater in New York City on 8th Avenue. Great times. Interplay, the group I was with. Tamara was with Split Second Theater, a wonderful group that she was working with. And we were busy. Every weekend we did shows. We helped with classes on the weekdays, the weeknights. So, and we weren't being paid. Okay, but we learned so much because you get to be on stage, you get to be in front of audiences. Someone says, hey, you know, I got this project I'd like you to be in. And you're like, okay, because they're your friend. And you didn't go, what's the pay? It's not about that.
Right.
And then that busyness does produce work because people come to see you and they go, you'd be great for this paying project.
Right.
So it really is about just, creating as much as possible what you want to do, finding other like-minded people. Because I know you're working on movie projects. You've got some different things that are in the burners, and you have friends that are doing things and creating stuff. And you can always sit down and write, and you can always record. We don't really have any excuses.
Mm-hmm.
We can get, we can fret through those lulls, or we can just use that time to go, wow, great. Now it's a lull. I have time to finish that short story.
Yeah.
I have time to read that script that guy gave me a million years ago and I never read.
Yeah.
I have time to put into class. All this time because there's a lull. And when you put your sometimes when you take your focus off the train and put it on something else over here, it seems like the train kind of goes, what are you looking at? Hey, I'm going to come and see what you're doing. And all of a sudden the train is in your backyard and you go like, oh, I guess I could get on the train now. I mean, I don't even care. And you get on and ride the train.
Okay. And then one other question for you. Ideally, you're able to just create art all the time, but there's also is this factor of that we have to pay bills and we have to make money and we live in planet Earth. Mm-hmm. But what would your advice be to people who have jobs other than those in the arts, but who want to do the arts?
Yeah. Well, you know, it's tough because I know most people don't have the freedom that we enjoy of having a pretty loose schedule. And, you know, it gets busy sometimes, but we're never like, we don't have to necessarily punch a clock at 8 a.m. till 5 or 9 to 6 or whatever. I've had that situation and I just really, really didn't like it. So, but if you're in that situation, and many, many people are, working one job and then they're working another job.
Yeah.
And on the weekends, maybe another job. And then there are Uber drivers in between. I don't know.
Like, how do you stay true to your purpose despite all of that?
I think you have to recognize, and Gary Vaynerchuk talks about this a lot, that you are probably wasting time somewhere. You're watching Game of Thrones. You're watching, Gary Vaynerchuk always talks about The Crown, and which I happen to think is a great show. But he obviously doesn't. I mean, you can see how it just doesn't integrate with his New Jersey background at all. The Crown? The Crown? But I think, I mean, all of us, I mean, I've thought about it many times as I'm sitting kind of like a cow chewing and just doing nothing or watching TV or often too, maybe there's someone who's talking to me and they're like not a great friend, not a partner, not somebody I'm working with necessarily, but they just feel like they have to talk and talk and talk. And in my mind, I'm going, my time is better used elsewhere, you know, but I'm going to listen to this person. But at a certain point, you have to go, you know what, I have to leave and do something for myself, do something creative or whatever. So J.K. Rowling is a great example. The myth of J.K. Rowling is that when she was waiting, you know, had no money and was waiting in a laundromat, she had yellow legal paper and she filled that paper with the Harry Potter story. These basic components of creative empires consist of paper, pencils, a little bit of free time, and imagination. And imagination is the key thing. The ability to, you know, have this spark and pay attention to it. And most of us go through the day not paying attention to that spark that we get, which can come at any time, and which you can actually kind of manufacture and tease along into growth. Or they either don't notice it, or they go, I don't have time, I can't do anything with that. However, they will sit in the restroom at work and look, go on Instagram for 7 minutes. They will, those people.
7 minutes.
7-8 minutes.
Yeah, it's true. It's true. Very, very good points. Well, this is all really interesting and
I hope so.
We can go on.
I hope it's helpful. Yeah, it's true. It's reinforcing what I believe for sure.
Really makes a lot of sense.
That's what Jim and Tay have their say and then work it out. Hey, hey.
Let us know what you think, and if that was helpful to you, thanks for watching. We really appreciate it. Click subscribe if you haven't already. This guy's got tons more great videos.
Ring my bell.
Have a great day.